again, such a complex situation. Jennifer Griffin just said money is the backdrop here to the Afghanistan war. You have the leader of that country threatening, essentially, the United States. And more importantly, we also have lives on the line there. What is the way forward in Afghanistan?
Well, the touchstone has to be what's in America's strategic interest, and that interest is in keeping Taliban and al-Qaeda from taking over again and using Afghanistan as a base for terrorism. Now, let's go through some of these complications. Number one, I hope Hamid Karzai is simply popping off for his domestic constituency. Our government needs to have a very serious conversation with him. It's obviously not helpful what he's saying. The notion that we wouldn't bomb houses or homes is simply an invitation to the Taliban and al-Qaeda to hide out in people's homes. So that obviously is going nowhere. Now, it's sometimes hard for the government, our government, to have these difficult conversations. Let me help them out a little bit as a private citizen. Somebody needs to say to President Karzai that he is a functionary as part of our effort to keep Taliban from taking control, and he needs to recognize that and behave appropriately, number one.
What happens if he doesn't?
Well, then I think in there are ways of dealing with him that just put him back in his place. These public statements are not helpful. He is not a bystander here in a war between us and the Taliban. His country's government is on the line, and he needs to be told it bluntly, like I just did. Now, number two, in terms of the money at stake, I don't doubt there's a lot of money we could save by cutting back on expenditures for so-called nation building. I don't think there's any evidence it's getting us the social contract that the theory behind nation building is supposed to build, that is to say, loyalty to the United States military effort, loyalty to the Karzai government. I think what we should not cut back are expenditures for our military effort, especially after having gotten bin Laden. This is the time to step up military pressure.
You know, some say, though, of course, that really the threat from terrorism is really coming from Yemen right now. And I'd like to move there just for a moment, if we could, Ambassador, because that's where some of the foiled plots have come from over the last year, from the underwear bomber to Major Nadal Hassan being inspired by the American cleric that we believe is based in Yemen. It looks like chaos there. This is a government that we have backed, or at least have had a relationship with, for about three decades now. What is the way forward there?
Well, the government is coming apart, and I think in part it's because we have not been clear that either the Saleh government follows through on its commitments to its people, or whoever replaces it is fully prepared to back us in the war against terrorism. I think our incoherence there has helped contribute to the instability, and there is a risk that Yemen as a state could fall apart, and in an anarchic situation, it could be used as a base for terrorism.
Is that a bigger threat than Afghanistan?
It could be a bigger threat. The world has many threats in it. We've got to deal with them. I think the best solution going forward is the efforts by the Gulf Cooperation Council, the other states on the Arabian Peninsula, to try and broker a deal here. I think our influence at this point is fairly minimal, unfortunately. I think our best bet is to get behind the GCC countries.
Ambassador, are you still considering running for president?
I am still considering running for president. When I hear situations like this, it just fires me up.
All right. We'll stay up to date with you on all those topics, including the one for 2012, Ambassador. Nice to have you. Thank you.